Yes, Mr. President.
We're still having lots of trouble with our port and Saigon, and I'm really shocked that they would raise hell about making all of our planes land there to collect the fee. I think somebody ought to shake the teeth out of them. Have you been reading? I wrote yesterday, prepared two-page memo where we've been spending, I don't know, I guess we sent a dozen messages back and forth to Saigon on trying to get them to let us use some other airports to land their planes, and they say no because they have a good charge on Saigon. They want to collect the revenue, which looked to me like it's just outrageous in wartime for a friendly government to put it to us that way. Now I hear that we have 750 barges that are clogging the port. And I've read a long explanation from Lodge about what he's been doing and how he's been trying and who he's seen, how many miles he's traveled and how the weather is, all of which is totally irrelevant. I don't give a damn. You've heard my modus operandi story, haven't you, about the postmaster?
No.
Well, when I first went to Washington, a country politician down here who was most important in our district wrote congressman I worked for and said he wanted his brother-in-law to be postmaster. He's starving and eating rabbits. And my congressman was very much like I inherited a lot of his tendencies. But he was pretty involved in his reply. And it took about three pages, and he said he'd met Jim Farley down at the National Press Club where he was speaking, and he had talked to him about the general postmaster situation and the new policy the Congress would have, and they'd have to have appropriations, and they'd have to have authorizations, and that they couldn't get around to it till January, and it would take about March to get it through the House, and then April to get it through the Senate, and he didn't think it could get much policy established until June, and 3.5 pages of it. This old boy replied to him by just putting his thumb down on the capital and capitalizing everything he said. Said, I don't give a good goddamn about the... And so the congressman wound up the letter by saying, as soon as we get the modus operandi worked out, I'll be back in touch with you. This old boy said, my brother-in-law's eating rabbits. I don't give a good goddamn about the modus operandi. What I want is the postmastership from my brother-in-law. Now, that's where I am with Lodge's explanation, and I thought maybe, after I looked over my cabinet up and down, and read all these wires from Lodge and from Comer and from others, that two things might happen since I talked to you about the mail. One is somebody shake them up out there about not letting us land wherever we want to. And the fee ought to be very much consideration in these kind of times. Second, Lodge gives three or four reasons. He says there's a question of the importer's ability to locate their cargo. Well, I'd find somebody to help them locate it and get it out. Second, there are importers who do not wish to take their cargo out of the port rapidly because they have no warehouses or because they expect price increases. So these importers, we feel the government should wield a club, confiscate their goods, and blacklist them from further import licenses. I intend to speak to the Prime Minister. Third, the shortage of adequate credit has prevented importers from getting financing, and thus they cannot remove them from the port. The economic counselors discussed this at length and so forth. Now, I thought maybe you ought to say to Westmoreland to really get with Lodge, and if they can't get all these things, I'm not interested in the modus operandi. Well, we'll just see if we can't tell them, we'll have the Army do it or somebody do it, so we just don't have 750 stacked up there, making it vulnerable from any standpoint. And they've got all the congressmen out there, and they'll all be wiring. Hello.
There's only one way to do it, Mr. President, and that's for us to take over the port.
Well, how do we get that done?
Well, if you have to say the key, we think we ought to do it.
Well, let's do that.
Stop arguing about whether it's wise or not wise, or whether we'll be hauled into court for liability because we pushed somebody's goods out of it or some other damn reason. The fact is that it isn't working, hasn't worked, he has promised many things he hasn't performed on. I think we ought to send a message out to Lodge and just say, we want you to go to Key and tell him that the court's clogged, that we're getting criticized in Congress for it, that he, his economy is being penalized for it, and we think that we ought to take it over. Period.
All right, now can you say something about airport at the same time?
Sure, sure.
Will you draft that and get Walt to do it? Just go ahead and let's move.
Yep.
Just tell him I got all the heat I can take in this country without having Henry Jackson saying there's 750 stacked up there.
Sure, we'll do it. Bye. Bye.